We've scouted out the factory's infestation pit based to listen to how many infestors there are or where they're located. So the Terran player may think he's in better shape here than he actually is. He's got an advantage on the ground, and you can see that their armies are almost equal in cash value there. They're left hand corner, so both players have about the same number of resources committed to their army, so that a certain player has a lot more gas. That's because of those infestors, which are so powerful. Watch for the fungal infestation, but it's sure to be a close battle here. This will be something that causes the units hit to stop moving and then explode.
Oh, and here we have the infestors. They're ticking up to like 148, 149, almost the 150 that they're going to need to cast that final infestation. And there we go, we have it casted. We can see it on the Marauder in the middle of the screen ticking down very quickly. And there he goes, he explodes in a second final infestation. He's going to take out five of those Marauders at once, backed up by those roaches. That Terran had no chance.
What a brutal blow. What was amazing with this Zerg player is using that final infestation to really just tear up that force. The Terran player really had no idea what he was up against. He thought he had the advantage there. He definitely had the advantage on the ground, but he didn't see those infestors secretly hidden under the ground, using their powerful abilities to really tear into his infantry swarm. If he wants to survive against those infestors, he's going to need to build some more powerful forces, something, some vehicles, or maybe some areas to defend himself. As it is, he's going to continue to be vulnerable to the attack from those infestors.